Welcome to the Louisiana Department of Health Clean Well Water presentation. This video will talk about all the parts that go into making your water well safe and operate correctly. We've chosen a well that is not enclosed to better show you all the parts and procedures. When you approach your well site, you want to make sure that it's clean as well as the area around the site. Remove any limbs and debris that might have collected up against your well. The debris may not harm your well, but is good practice to maintain a clean well site. This site is exposed to the elements, and leaves and branches can collect around the base. But most wells are found inside protective enclosures or well houses. If yours is outside an enclosure, you'll have to perform maintenance more often. So remove all the debris, making sure not to damage the well site. That way you can see all the parts and be able to determine if there are any problems and that there are no leaks. Stand back from the well so you can better see if there are any issues. Walk around the well to make sure it's clear of any debris that may impact the operation of the well. Make sure there are no significant or even minor problems with the well or the site itself. Now that you've inspected your site, let's go over the different parts and how to take a water sample. The parts that enter the ground are the well casing and pipe. The pipe goes down into the ground until it reaches fresh water. What protects that pipe is the well casing. Most of the time, the well casing is made of concrete. Make sure that it's at least 12 inches above the ground level. Clear away any soil or debris that may have collected around it. This is what keeps contaminants from entering the well site and seals it closed at the ground level. You want to make sure it's in good shape and it's solid and there are no cracks or crumbling pieces. If there are, you should contact a certified well driller and they will come out and repair your site. This is very important to the well and the water you drink from it. Conduct a visual and physical inspection of the well equipment. You want to make sure all the connections are solid and that there are no loose parts or pieces. Here's where the electricity enters the well. This connection goes to the bottom of the well and activates the pump that pumps the water to the surface. There's a screen on the bottom that keeps the loose debris from entering the well pump. It's important to the function of the well and moving the water up the shaft through your piping and into your well tank. If you suspect an issue with the screen around the pump, contact a licensed water well driller for an inspection. Issues may vary from sediment appearing in your drinking water to increased mechanical failure. Above ground, what protects the well site is your casing and your well cap. It is very important to make sure they are not damaged. Please check the screws and bolts to make sure they are tight and nothing is loose. You may see a little rust, and that's okay. It happens from time to time. But if you see any damaged parts or extensive corrosion, call a certified well water driller to repair them. You can find a list at the Louisiana Department of Natural Resources website or the Louisiana Department of Health Private Well Initiative website. Check and make sure your tank is also in good shape. No damaged pieces, no significant rust, cracks, or leaks. As that water is pumped through the well pipe, it will go into your pressure tank. Your tank is going to fill partially with air and partially with water. It does not fill completely with water. This is so the air can push the water from the tank into the pipe and into your home. So the water goes into your tank. It enters here and there's a valve, a shutoff valve. So you can turn the water off to your home in case you need to do any repairs inside the home on the water lines. At the moment, it's off because it's at 90 degrees to the pipe. If the valve was in line with the pipe, it would be on and the water would be flowing into your home. Another commonly used valve is a gate valve, like this one. This is the sample tap. This is where you would take the sample directly from the well itself. It is the closest sample point to the well. The sample you turn in for testing will come from this spigot. You can see that when I turn the valve, the water begins to flow. And this is something you want to do every so often. It flushes the valve and makes sure it's in working order. You don't want to try and take a sample and find your spigot doesn't work. It only takes a few minutes, but you should ensure that your well is working properly and that there are no cracks or leaks. Turn the faucet on and off a few times just to make sure it's in proper working order. Just like the plumbing in your house, you don't want any mechanical problems. Make sure nothing is loose or broken. It may seem like we're overemphasizing that you should be testing your well, but it's a practice that will keep you and your family drinking safe, clean water. If your well site is exposed, as this one is, and it's not inside a well house, you definitely want to make sure that any of the exposed piping that contains water is shielded from the environment. If we get a hard freeze and your pipes are not insulated, the pipes could break, resulting in loss of water pressure to the home and potential contaminants entering the well. So be sure to check the insulation around the pipes and make sure it's protected from the elements. This well site is in great shape. I do not see anything that needs to be repaired or adjusted. Back to the sample tap. This one happens to be pointing straight down, but some others may be horizontal and the water actually shoots out sideways. Or they're very low to the ground and it's difficult to get a sample bottle underneath them. These situations can be problematic, so speak to your water well driller, a plumber, or your parish health representative who can help you find a solution. We highly recommend that you get enough distance from the ground so you can get a bottle under the spigot for an uncontaminated sample. With this spigot, you can turn it on and flush it out without any backsplashing. And since it's facing down, with plenty of room for a sample bottle to get underneath, we'll be able to easily get a well sample. This is an example of what a well tap should look like. So, to review, when you're inspecting your well site, you want to make sure that your area has a gradual slope away from the site. After removing debris, you do not want any depressions or anything that would allow standing water or debris up against or around your site. You also want to make sure that your casing is in good shape and that your well cap is at least 12 inches above the ground surface. If any of these inspection points do not meet your criteria, you can always call a water well driller who will make the necessary repairs. Beyond the things we just talked about, there are other precautions to take to make sure your well water is clean, safe, and maintained. You want to make sure your well is at least 25 feet away from another water well. If they're within those 25 feet from one another, it may reduce the amount of water produced for your well. You also want to make sure, and this is very important, that your well is at least 50 feet from a septic tank or individual wastewater system. If you have any questions or would like more information, please call this number, contact your parish health unit, or visit this website.